Hello, welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to talk about an interesting option in Illustrator's image trays. So these are all images and I want to auto trace them. I'm going to Window and Image Trays to open the Image Trays panel, and then I can select one of those images and trace it. I'm going to use the black and white setting because that's a black and white template and I want just black and white output. So just click on it and Illustrator has now traced this. It's not yet a path, it's just a live object, an image tracing object as can be seen above. So the interesting option can be found in the advanced section. I'm going to open that and here we have the method, which is automatically set to abutting. And there's another option which is overlapping, and let's select this other image and trace that as well and set it to overlapping. Now, if we want to see what's happening here, we have to expand these two. So select them both and hit expand. And now we've got paths. So let's go to view, outline, and there we have the paths. They look the same. So why does this option even exist? Let's go to the preview again and let's ungroup this. I'm going to ungroup this and that one as well. And now in order to see what's happening here, I'm just going to move this one and I'm going to move that one. And you see, we have different objects here. We've got three objects. Let's go to outline view again. There's a rectangle and two circles. And on that side, we have also three objects, but actually four paths. This is a compound path, and then we have another compound path here, and we have this path. So that's this one. And let's undo that, like so. And you see these paths, they are exactly neighbored. Again, outline view, and they are really exactly neighbored. There's no overlap. Let's go out of here again. But here we've got this nice overlap. Now, that's a nice thing because we can edit that path and we don't get into issues, like so. No problem with that. Do the same here and you see we've got the background. Now, for these, it's not as big as an issue as with this one, for instance. So I'm going to trace this one. Let's select the auto setting and then let's go to overlapping. Takes a minute, expand that. And you see, this is editable now. So we have all these shapes and we could edit those paths if there's a line we don't like. It's easily editable. But of course, it also has consequences when we want to clean that up. For instance, I actually don't want to have that white. So I don't like that. I don't need that. Now, what do I do then? So for that to try out, I'm going to turn on a copy of these images and let's just trace them again. So let's do the black and white and let's do the black and white here and set that to overlapping. And then let's check it out again. Now, when I don't want the white, there's an option to ignore white. And you see, when this is set to abutting, you can turn on ignore white and you don't get the white. This is not possible here. So when you have overlapping, you can't turn that on. And also, when I'm going to expand this, you also have to be careful when later deleting that. So you can delete this one, of course. But when you delete that one, you just got the circle. So if you want to edit that later on, what you have to do is select these two and then go to Object and Compound Path, Make, and there we have the result. Now, let's turn that off again and let's take a look at these. So obviously, it's not really possible to stack them. So let's see what Illustrator does. Now I'm going to trace this one and trace that one and go to the overlapping option. And let's just select them and expand them. And then we take a look at this. And you see here we've got the neighboring ones. And in here, when I select this, it's neighboring as well. So what happened here? Now I'm going to zoom in a little further and let's go into outline view. And you see they are not actually neighbored, but they are slightly overlapping. So it would be still possible to have some edits. And it also has another advantage. So you might have seen that when you expand a live trace of some photo or a colored graphic and you have a couple of colors in it, and when you expand that, you get these ugly thin white lines between all those shapes. Those are caused by anti-aliasing. But when you select this option of overlapping, then you get at least these slight overlaps, and then the anti-aliasing won't happen to white. So that is another benefit of the overlapping option. Now, you know what these two buttons do, and you can decide if you need them and when you need them. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.